According to Businje, they have done all the sensitization engagements and asked the community to respect the activity since it benefits all citizens in the country. He asked residents seeking to do other activities, including animal grazing, fish farming, among others from wetlands, to seek permission from the Natural Resources Department at their respective districts.
Respect the activity we are doing, because we are doing it for the benefit of all of us, for our country, for the present and future generations. And where we have put our marker, the demarcation point, we request that the activity is being done down. Please, you have to get permission.
Businje says if anyone violates the process, they are likely to face a penalty of 600 million shillings or be imprisoned for 12 years or serve both.
Wetland degraders, if you are arrested and prosecuted, you can be required to pay over 600 million or arresting, or you can be imprisoned for 12 years or both.
Wilson Miranda, the Kagadi District Internal Security Officer, on behalf of the resident district commissioner, explained that the communities have encroached on wetlands and this has changed the pattern of rain supply across the country. Miranda says locals neighboring the Honra wetland boundaries should not encroach on it for farming activities. I want to thank all the leaders who are here as we are launching the demarcation of our wetland in Kagadi. Most of our wetlands have been encroached on, and they're important in giving us a number of raw materials, including water, but also tourism. We are supposed to preserve the sources of water as people of Kagadi. Gerald Biona, the Kagadi District Environment Officer, says after the demarcation exercise, the Environment and Natural Resources Department will develop a wetland management plan that will guide them on activities that can be conducted in the restored wetlands.
Then that wetland management plan will give us points of action through which we identify activities or enterprises.
Oliver Asimwe Irumba, the Chairperson Natural Resources Committee, Kagadi District, commended residents for complying with the exercise and says this will help communities know where usable land starts from.
Can demarcate and show the community that they're supposed to stop or to use that part which is going to be used by them.
Valentino Biarugaba, the LC1 chairperson, Kambogo Village in Muhoro sub-county, and Fuderi Rurangirana, the resident who owns the land where the demarcation exercise was launched, welcomed the exercise and said they are ready to comply with the environmental conservation guidelines.
We are going on to sensitize them and have some meetings in villages, parishes, and other areas.
Anyone practicing agriculture or living near the wetland should accept and welcome the government program of wetland restoration, and I will respect the boundaries. I will leave the land in the wetland to regenerate, and I will use it with guidance from authorities. According to the National Wetlands, Riverbanks and Lakeshores Management Act, a person who shifts concrete pillars erected to demarcate wetland boundaries is fined 600 million shillings or serves 12 years imprisonment or both. Kagadi District is among the districts in Uganda leading in destruction of wetlands, encroachment on natural resources and ecosystems. Report compiled by Thomas Tumwebaze for the news.